right? Shalom, shalom, Makiam. Like the first and foremost, give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakadash, double honor to the elders and the apostles, the great millstone on the road to teach the world. The most peace, safety, and blessings to the elect of that throughout the four winds scattered, you know, pushing the truth to sincerity and diligence. All right, his brother, y'all from the great millstone, Lake Charles, Louisiana camp, you know, coming back again, you know, through, you know, the spirit of Paul, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, with another lesson. And as always, you know, Lord, will it be edifying to the Lord's elect? You know, and, you know, within this particular lesson, you know, ultimately just want to touch upon, you know, as you can see the title, how, you know, Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai is allowing the spirits, you know, on each side, you know, to get, ramped up, you know, as far as what dealing with Jacob and Esau, all right? And, you know, ultimately the whole nation of Israel, you know, versus the heathens, you know, chiefly against Esau, Edom. All right, let me start with that one too. I'll start with that one, all right, because what we're yet, you know, this day in our captivity, okay, and it's set in stone that what Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai has delivered unto us, you know, the mysteries, the prophecies, all right, and he's let us know, you know, that what he's our God, and he's only for us, you know, and deliverance is only coming for us, you know, Lord willing, we be of the precious elect. You know, but it's set in stone who the Heavenly Father and the only begotten Son truly are. You know, and it have been made manifest to us, okay, because it had been hidden. All right. So this is Hosea 1. I'm gonna start at verse 7. All right. It says, "But I will have mercy upon the house of Judah, and I will save them by the Most High Yahweh their power, and will not save them by bow nor by sword, nor by battle by horses, nor by horsemen." Now when he had weaned Loruhamah, she conceived and bare a son. Then said Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai, "Call his name Lo-Ami, or Lo-Ami." It says, "For ye are not my people, and I will not be your power," because where we had that falling away. All right, according to prophecy, we had that time to we wasn't called the sons of Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai. All right, it was a mystery. All right, we ultimately, you know, forsook and departed away from our heritage, okay? But as we go into Hosea, the fifth chapter, you know, 5 and 15, all right, as we all know, it basically states that what the Lord would turn his back until we acknowledge and confess our faults before him, okay? Verse 10, it says, "Yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sand of the sea," all right? Going right back to what Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai had promised to Abraham, okay? We will be an innumerable nation, okay? A nation that was going to bring forth much fruit, you know, and ultimately showing the heathens too that what we can never be done away with, all right? As it speaks about in the book of Romans, the 11th chapter, okay, concerning how what the Lord casts us away for a period of time, but he didn't fully do away with us, okay? Because what he promised us, the covenants, the blessings, the glory, you know? Us to be called after his name, what to receive, what it says, an incorruptible inheritance, okay? It says, which cannot be measured nor numbered, speaking about our nation, all right? You Negroes, Latinos, and Natives, all right? It says, and this shall come to pass that in the place wherein it was said unto them, ye are not my people, there it shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living power, you know? And it's made manifest that the power that we serve, Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai, is a living God, okay? And we're made living through the word, okay? So everything that Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai, you know, had spoken, all right, and had put into effect us, into effect so that we may be partakers and receivers, you know, of the deliverance, you know, of having the heathens as a possession, you know, it's all playing out right before our eyes, all right, in this present captivity, okay? Verse 11, it says, "Then shall the children of Judah and the children of Israel be gathered together." And that's why you see what the northern kingdoms and the southern kingdoms coming together. All right. You see Issachar hanging with Jake, you know, Ephraim with Jake, with Judah, you know, so forth and so on. Manasseh, you know, so forth and so on, man. But that's because what the spirit of Yahweh Bashimi Al-Shai and what brought us together. Okay. And now what the heathen are dismayed, okay? The heathen are infuriated at that, you know, because what they set up laws, they set up certain confederates, they set up certain things to where what divisions would be amongst the northern tribes and the southern tribes, you know. But according to prophecy, they can't stop it. They couldn't stop it, you know. They only could do so for a period of time. All right. Continuing on, it says, and appoint themselves one head, and they shall come up out of the land. You see, out of the land of what? The north. Okay, as it speaks about in the book of Jeremiah, the 16th chapter. This is the present land where Yahweh Hashem Yahshua is going to gather us up from. Okay, into the chariots. All right. It says, for great shall be the day of Jezreel. All right. Going into the deliverance, man, of us being taken up out of this place. Okay, us coming together. All right, which is beautiful now, but it's going to get even more better, you know, once we have everything fully restored, you know, according to how it's supposed to be. All right. So it ultimately brings me to Genesis, the 49th chapter. Okay, when it goes into how, you know, for a period of time, when you look at the so-called Negroes, right? When you look at the so-called Negroes for a great period of time, they constantly kiss this devil's ass, you know, a straight to the point, you know. They will crouch greatly, you know. You can't get them to stand up against this devil. But now what the Lord is allowing, that certain, powerful and boldful spirit to overcome our nation, all right? And it's going to get even more powerful as this devil, you know, because the Lord is going to have Esau Edom with that same mindset, okay, that he had in the beginning when he says, well, I will rise up and slay my brother Jacob, you know. That's what the whole, you know, Revelations 12 and 12, you know, has to ultimately counterplay out to as well. You know, it's going in, it's ultimately taking place hand in hand. You know, they're going to show that wrath because they understand that what? It's time for us to rise up and rule. You know, so the Lord is going to pour out that spirit of, you know, treacherous dealings upon Esau, Edom, you know, just so that he can show his power with the nation, you know, which he loves. Okay. And ultimately, the Lord is going to lift up the standard for the elect, okay? Because that's what everything is ultimately surrounded by, okay? The elect rising up and having power by way of calling upon the true names of the Heavenly Father and only begotten Son, you know? But this is Genesis 49 and 9. It says, Judah is a lion's whelp from the prey, my son, thou art going up. He stooped down, he crouched as a lion. As an old lion, if you know anything about an old lion, right, once they get to a certain age, they have no more fight in them, you know. Now when you look at you know how so-called Negroes are here in captivity, especially them old jakes, they don't got no fight in them, you know. They rather just, you know, take Esau's shit and keep it moving, you know. But what the Lord is going to pour out that bold spirit, okay. It says he crouched as a lion and as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? You see, but what? It's going to be of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua's power, okay, to rise Jacob, all right, to get them to where they're in the mindset of saying, man, to hell with this devil, you know, and it's going to be beautiful, okay? It's going to be beautiful because ultimately what these heathen, all right, these heathen has to come to grip. All right, with who they really are. It speaks about them in the book of Isaiah, the 40th chapter, they're like unto spittle. You know, and it's going to be made known. All right. It's going to be made known. This is Obadiah verse 15. I started verse 15. All right. It says, for the day of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua is near upon all the heathen. You know, and once the day of the Lord ultimately approaches you, it's going to be great divisions. You know, the scriptures speak about how every nation is going to go to their own, you know. But what, through that, hey, you Edomites and you other heathenistic nations are going to get a great wake-up call, all right? The Lord, it says, what, the Lord have made you, what, let me get it, Obadiah verse 2, behold, I have made thee small among the heathen, thou art greatly despised, speaking about Esau, Edom, you know? You are small among the heathen, you are the basest of men, but yet you have that great pride that's in you, you know? But that pride is going to get shot down, you know? You see, that's what they fail to realize. You're not, you know, the Esau isn't built the way he portrays to be, you know. It's because they're on that high horse. But what, the Lord is going to take them down from that, you know. Trusting in your weaponry, trusting in your military, you know. The Lord has another thing coming for you Edomites here in the land of America, all right. This is Obadiah 1 and verse 15. Okay, it says, for the day of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is near upon all the heathen, because the day of the Lord isn't going to be a pleasing time for you. It's not a time to where you can restore and make America great again. It's not a time to where you can, tread upon the Israelites and you get the victory. No, that's not what prophecy has to offer. All right. Prophecy is against you. All right. It says, as thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee, and thy reward shall return upon thine own head. And you haven't reaped anything good in the earth, you know. You haven't sowed anything good in the earth, so you're not going to reap anything good. All right. Your payback is at hand. Verse 16, it says, for as ye have drunk upon my holy mountain, which is what drinking and ultimately receiving benefits off of the back of Israel. All right. Off of the blood, sweat, and tears of the Israelites. It says, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink, and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance. So who is Mount Zion? All right. Who is that speaking about? Speaking about the elect of you Negroes, Latinos, and Natives. Deliverance is only for you. Okay. It says, and there shall be holiness. Because that's what we're going back to, man. All right, a righteous nation. All right, the nation that have ultimately been called after the Heavenly Father. Okay, His pureness and, you know, His glory is gonna reign over us. All right, we're gonna dwell under the wings of the Almighty in our fullness. All right, it says, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. All right, going into the spoils, you know. We're going to own everything, even when it goes to, let me get it real quick. Psalms, I believe it's 2 and 8. Yep, this is Psalms chapter 2 and 8. It says, ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance. All right, let's get this word inheritance real quick. Which, it, when you continue to go on, it says, in the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. All right, but when we inherit something, right, let's see what it says. It says something inherited or occupancy to be occupied with, right? It says generally an estate, a portion, a heritage, possession. You see? So the heathen are going to be our possessions, okay? The heathens are going to be our possession, meaning what we're going to be able to do whatever we want with it. Let me get this real quick. Let's go to the... and get this word possession. Right, it says the act or fact of holding, occupying, owning. We're gonna own you. All right, it says thing possessed, that which is possessed, material or landed property. You're gonna be our property. It says lands, goods, or rights owned. We're gonna have rights, you know. It says we're going to own you, okay? And you're not going to be able to, it says a seizing of possession, you know? Because when you look at, oh my goodness. Hey, it says the state of being under the control of evil spirits or of madness, the state, mainly the state of being under control of, you know, of our power, okay? So whatever we want you to do, that's what you're going to do. It says a possessor, okay? To have and hold, to hold in one's control, to be master of. We're going to be the world's new masters, okay? We're going to be the new masters of the earth, all right? And there's nothing you're going to be able to do about it, you know? Verse 18, it says, and the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame. And the house of Esau for stubble. This is what you're going to be. You're going to be like a chaff. All right. It says, and they shall kindle in them and devour them. Because if I'm not mistaken, I believe it said that in Psalms 2 and 9. Yep. Let me get it. Psalms 2 and 9. It says, thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. Thou shalt dash them into pieces like a potter's vessel. You see? So that's why in this chapter continues to tell us, Be wise now, therefore, O ye kings, be instructed, ye judges of the earth. Serve Yahweh Bashim Yahshua with fear and rejoice with trembling. You see? Because as we continue to do the will of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, work out our own salvation with fear and trembling, we understand what we're soon to inherit. Okay? Let me get verse 12. I love this verse. It says, kiss the son, lest he be angry. Ultimately what? Becoming peacemakers with Yahweh Shai. Because through Yahweh Shai, we get deliverance. Through Yahweh Shai, we're going to be what? It says, it tells us in the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, if we be joint heirs to Yahweh Shai's sufferings, then we're going to be joint heirs receiving the kingdom. Okay? It says, lest he be angry, and ye perish from the way. When his wrath, it says, when his wrath is kindled but a little, blessed are all they that put their trust in him. And this is what the faith and the patience of the saints. Okay? Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. We're putting our trust in Yahweh Shai because what? He's going to be the one to deliver us. He's going to own up to his name. Okay? He's going to grant us the kingdom. He's going to continue to talk to the Heavenly Father Yahweh for us and plead our cases. You know? And as we continue to do these things and wait upon him to deliver us, hey, the heathen will be our possessions, man. Okay? The heathens will be our possession, and there's not going to be nothing, you know, that they can do. Okay? Let me go back to this. This is Obadiah 1. And I'm going to start at verse 18 again. It says, and the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stubble, and they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for the Most High Yahweh has spoken. You see? So the Lord is soon to what? Ultimately, you know, turn the captivity of the Israelites. All right? And this is going to be the last captivity wherewith these devils are going to be able to have pride, you know, and boast themselves and, you know, be over us. All right? Which they're only over us because we, you know, we were found with fault, okay, with the Heavenly Father. Okay? But those times are ultimately over with. Okay? As we continue to look at the prophecy, man. All right? There's only so much that these devils are going to be allowed to do, you know? Look at the one when it says, Lord, hold his peace no more. Let me see.
For behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall no more be said, the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north, and from all the lands whither he had driven them.
That same God, Yahweh, through his son Yahweh Shai, is going to deliver the same people in this time that we're living in. And the scriptures tell it clearly. If your eye have been opened to see these things, there's no way no other nation can make it into our kingdom, which is the kingdom of Yahweh Shai. There's no way. They're going to be servants.
But thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because ye were more in number than any people, when ye were the fewest of all people. But because the Lord loved you, and because he would keep the oath which he had sworn unto your fathers, after the Lord brought you out with a mighty hand, and redeemed you out of the house of bondmen, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
You can totally see it. You can totally see that the same God, Yahweh, that was delivering the children of Israel out of all type of captivities. When they went off, it's the same power of Yahweh that's gonna send his son back, Yahweh Shai, who is of our nation, to deliver the elect in these last days before Esau Edom, when his establishment of his new world order is totally destroyed. That's what's getting ready to happen. Ain't nothing else getting ready to happen but that.
Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall no more be said, the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But the Lord liveth, that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north, and from all the lands whither he had driven them.
We'll read this one more time. This is Exodus 14:14.
Barakatai Yahweh Shai. Barakatai Yahweh. Barakatai Yahweh. Barakatai Yahweh Shai.
Bring you a peace. You know? So what we ultimately have to continue to do, you know, is stay in the spirit, you know, continue to edify the flock, you know, and what, be found hasting the coming of our Lord, you know, continue to do the work, you know, and watch out, you know, for these prophecies, stay up on our watch, you know, and let the Lord handle everything else, you know. So with that, Lord willing, you know, this lesson was edifying. I'd like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakadash. Double line, see the elders and the apostles of great millstone to rule and teach well. You must peace, safety, and blessings to the hopeful elect. Throughout the four winds, pushing his truth and sincerity and the diligence. Till next time, Shalom.